Using power series to solve a homogeneous differential equation, 2x squared y double prime plus 3xy prime plus 2x minus 1 times y equals 0. And you are given that x equals 0 is a regular singular point, so our solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity, cn n x to the n plus r. Take the first derivative, gives me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r x to the n plus r minus 1. Take the second derivative, gives me power series from 0 to infinity, cn n plus r minus 1 x to the n plus r minus 2. So when you take the derivative, just bring down the exponent and then subtract the exponent by 1, okay? Now I'm going to plug these into the differential equation, but before I do that, I'm gonna distribute this out. So I have 2x squared y double prime plus 3xy prime plus 2x times y minus y is equal to 0. Now I'm gonna plug these into this one. So I have power series from 0 to infinity, 2cn n plus r minus 1 times x to the n plus r. So you have x squared times x to the n plus r minus 2, so 2 minus 2, which is 0, okay? Plus power series from 0 to infinity, 3cn n plus r x to the n plus r. Again, you have x times x to the n plus r minus 1, so 1 minus 1, which is 0. Plus power series from 0 to infinity, 2cn x to the n plus r plus 1. Now for this one, you have x times x to the n plus r, so you have 1. You have to add the exponent together, which gives me n plus r plus 1 minus power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n plus r is equal to 0. Right? Now we are going to take a look at the index. So when n equals 0, plug in 0, I have x to the r, n equals 0, x to the r, n equals 0, x to the r plus 1, n equals 0, x to the r. So x to the r plus 1 is the highest exponent. That means that we have to write down terms for the other power series. So for the first one, plug in 0, I have 2c naught r times r minus 1 x to the r plus power series from 1 to infinity 2cn n plus r minus 1 times x to the n plus r. Okay? Now for the second one, plug in 0, I have 3c naught times r x to the r plus the power series from 1 to infinity 3cn n plus r x to the n plus r. Okay, now for the third one. So remember I said this is what we want, because it's already x to the n plus x to the r plus 1 when you plug in 0. But if I take a step further, where after I run out of time for this one, I have n starts at 1 and this URL starts at 1, so it makes sense to reindex this to 1 to save time instead of rewrite it, and then after this step I have to rewrite it again. So going this step, I'm gonna reindex this to 1. So I have power series from 1 to infinity, so add 1. So I have to subtract 1 by raising 1 inside. So I have 2cn minus 1 x to the n plus r. Alright, finally, last one. Plug in 0, I have negative c naught x to the r minus power series from 1 to infinity cn x to the n plus r is equal to 0. Let me draw a line to separate these steps. Okay, good. Now we are going to combine items. So this is my leading coefficient of x to the r. Okay, can you guys see that? Yep. So I have two. Oh, and if I notice, I have c naught in common, right? So I'm gonna factor out c naught. So I have 2r squared minus 2r plus 3r, which gives me negative r, the positive r, minus 1. It's a little bit tricky if you cannot do everything at once in one step, so you can do it. You can do it in short paper, then rewrite your final answer into this one. But in order to save time for this type of problem, I'm gonna just do this, okay? Times x to the r. Now, plus power series from 1 to infinity. So I have cn, cn, cn in common, so factor it out. And this one has n plus r, so factor it out again. So I have n plus r, and in parentheses I have 2n plus 2r minus 2 plus 3, which gives me 1. Okay? And for the last one, it's just negative 1 plus this term, 2cn minus 1, all multiplied by x to the n plus r is equal to 0. Okay? Now we are going to equate coefficient. So let this equal 0 and let everything inside the big parentheses equal 0. So you have seen that. 2r squared plus r minus 1 equals 0. And see n plus r, 2n plus 2r plus 1 minus 1. Wrong place. Minus 1 plus 2 cn minus 1 equals 0. So this is my system of equations. Now I'm going to solve for r. But before I do that, I like to rewrite it in factor form because it's much easier to find solutions when it's in factor form. You just set each factor equals 0 and then you solve for the unknown. So I'm going to use a diamond method to find the factor here. So the two numbers add up to 1 and their product is negative 2, so 2 times negative 1, which is negative 2. So I have positive 2 and negative 1. And don't forget to divide by the least coefficient, okay? So eventually I have r plus 1 times r minus 1 half equals 0. Then solve for r, I have negative 1 and 1 half, okay? Do you see how easy it is when you write it in factor form? Just set this equal 0 and this equal 0, then just solve for r. So this is my r values. Now, when r equals negative 1, look into this one and solve for the biggest c, which is cn, and do the same, thing that we did earlier. So I move this up, okay? So I have cn, n minus, n minus 1. This one is 2n, negative 2 plus 1, negative 1, minus 1. Plus 2 cn minus 1 equals 0. Solve for the biggest c, which is cn. So I have negative 2 cn minus 1 over n minus 1, 2n minus 1 minus 1. And for this one, n is for this one, n is starting from 1 to infinity. No. From 2 to infinity. Why? Let me explain. So if you plug in 1, if you let n start as 1, so when you plug in 1, you have negative 2 c not over 0 because 1 minus 1 is 0, so you cannot divide by 0 and have to fix that. Because this is what we created. So we have to start, so we have to let n start at 2 instead of 1 because n doesn't work. So you have to start at the next one that doesn't make this become 0 or undetermined, okay? Now for the first term when n equals 1, you're gonna plug it into this one, okay? The origin of 1. Okay, so when n equals 1, so plugging into this one, I have C naught, C1 here actually, C1, so this becomes 0 times 1 minus 1 plus 2 C naught equals 0. So I solve for big C, which is C1, then I have C1 equals 2 C naught, okay? Now for n equals 2, we are going to use this one because it's valid for this. So I have C2 equals negative C1 over 2 minus 1, 2, 4, 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. What is C1? C1 is 2 C naught. Okay. So my solution is x to the r C naught plus C1 x plus C2 x squared plus that dot. And what is r? R is negative 1. So I have x to the negative 1. C1, you know, just write it. What is C1? C1 is 2 C naught. What is C2? C2 is 2 C naught. Okay, factor C naught. Then you have 1 plus 2x minus 2x squared plus that, right? Now we are going to do the same thing for r equals 1 half. So r equals 1 half. Plug in 1 half into this one, have Cn times n plus 1 half. And for this one, 2n. 2 times 1 half, which is 1, 1 plus 1 is positive 2, minus 1, plus 2, Cn minus 1, equals 0. Now I solve for Cn. So I have Cn equals negative 2n minus 1 over. So for this one, I see that we have 2 in common. So factor out 2 and multiply it into this one. So we have 2n plus 1. And for this one, I have n plus 1 minus 1. N is starting from 1 to infinity. Again, so for this case, n starting 1 is valid for this one. And remember back in to the previous one when r equals negative 1, n equals 1 is not valid for this one, so you have to use this instead and let n equals 2. But for this one, it works. Now, n equals 1, plugging 1, I have c1 equals negative 2c0 over 2, 3. So 2 plus 1, 3, 3 times 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5, and equal 2. So I have c2 equals negative 2c1 over 2, 4, 5, 5 times 3, 15, 14. So c1 over 7. So negative 1 over 7 times c1 is negative 2c0 over 5. So I have 2c0 over 35. Okay. So my y2 is equal to x to the r, c0 plus c1s plus c2 squared plus dot dot dot. What is r? R is 1 half. What is c0? We don't know to rewrite it. What is c1? C1 is negative 2c0 over 5. What is c2? C2 is 2c0 over 35 x squared plus dot dot dot. Factor c0. So I have c0 times x to the 1 half, 1 minus 2 fifths x plus 2 over 35 x squared plus dot dot dot. And our final solution, let me write it over here, try to squeeze it into one page. So our final solution is equal to y1 plus y2. And this is my y1, this is my y2. So keep in mind that these c naughts are not the same. So let me, for the first one, just rewrite it. I have c naught x to the negative 1, 1 plus 2x minus 2x squared plus dot dot dot. Plus for the second one, I'm going to call this c naught as c1. And everything else is just the same. So just rewrite it. Alright, so that's it. This is your final solution. Eventually.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.